Welcome! Welcome! Right, perfect timing. Did this go?
Hi!
Like, oh, we're gonna be. Perfect timing. Yeah, come in, please. Yeah.
Okay,
no. Did you close the door? Yeah. Thank you. You can come.
She said they need social distance.
Okay.
Do you want?
Or maybe, someone can move.
Here.
There are some more spots here on the floor if anyone wants to come sit on this really comfy rug.
Yeah. My visionary was making love in the bathtub.
That's gentle for you.
Does it sound like?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And anyway,
it was obvious.
Obvious. Anyway.
If you guys want to open, there's a kitchen, a window in the kitchen. If you guys want to open that, it'd be
cool. Yeah. And the second quality that I feel is mysterious. This time I won't tell you my freedom. You know, something too intimate, you know?
We're learning so much about you, Julian.
Yeah. Well, if you follow Julian on Facebook, you may already know about some of his baths.
Yeah. This is a secret language, you know?
This is a secret language.
Thank you.
quality is radiant, right? But the correlation of the one that I just did, we can talk about it afterwards. It's a bit too intimate to share in public.
More intimate than sex in the bathroom?
Ooh, yes.
Thank you.
Lovingness, right? Lovingness. I help myself with a cup of tea. It's really such a privilege for me to share music to you all, and really, what a privilege to have so many people listen to you talking nonstop for 2 hours. Really, it's truly an honor.
It's a privilege and honor for us, Julia.
Yes, thank you.
To listen to me talk about them.
Also, like, you're adding so much to our Hanukkah, you know, like, just,
yeah.
Like, also, what a unique perspective of, like, 8 qualities of light.
Yeah, I have been doing house concert here for 8 weeks already. Really, like, it's...
Consecutive.
Yeah, I'm really, really happy. I feel like from time to time I know more and more how to communicate with all my dear friends. Yeah. And also, like, it changed my relationships with the audiences. Like, I think for a lot of musicians or performers, like when they feel afraid, it's kind of like they put the audiences into the opposite side. Like, it's kind of, you know, like, I'm afraid of their judgment, but now I feel like you're part of me. Thank you.
Thank you.
silence. So we're going to be silent. Perhaps you can, I don't know.
Meditate?
Feel, no, not meditate, but like you can feel the silence that is projecting. So this is the stillness that I feel. And the seventh one is joy. Yeah, make yourself comfortable. Yeah, everyone, you're welcome to serve yourself something.
Have you played by Julia?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And I always feel like I have to play in my own wedding. But not in my own funeral, it's a bit difficult.
I want to bring you back with your fans.
Yeah, but I have I don't really think of what's the funeral music that I would love to listen.
Right.
Yeah. I want to listen Mahler's Second Symphony, The Resurrection. Yeah. It's 1.5 hours long and with a few hundred people in the orchestra and the choir, so it will be quite a scene. Okay, so enough joke, so we get back to
come in.
Come in.
Who's up the back?
And I'm always thinking, how can we bring a different way to do classical concerts? Yeah, because in the traditional way is the pianist, they don't say a word, right? And then the audience come in and then you play from the end, from the beginning to the end, and then bow and then clap. And I feel like the audience nowadays have less patience for that. Mm. It seems like, yeah. Mm. So maybe I have to mix playing Chopin with stand-up comedy.
But it's also nice to get to know your audience, and then we get to know you. You build rapport, and then we're much more interested in who you are and what you bring to the music.
Like Hafnia.
What is Hafnia?
Look him up later.
Okay. Yeah, if in Carnegie Hall, maybe it will be a bit different.
No.
Yeah, all right. So, joy.
And also just, folks who are near here, you're the kitchen, just be, you're fine. Just just be careful, the computer is on top and the cord, it's really delicate. Just make sure not to like move the plant or anything so the computer is on top.
So, please gather together.
Thank you.
fleeting ecstasy. It was hot. The last one. The last chapter. Yeah. The last chapter is
everlasting.
Everlasting, yes, everlasting. Yeah, like I have a story in my mind while.
Do you want to tell it to us?
Yeah. Like,
stories are great.
Yeah, stories are great. Like this is everlasting. I mean, like I there's something I imagined while I did it like, today. Yeah. Because I think like the brightest light is love, right? And of course, I think like the brightest light is emotionless. Emotionless love. No, yeah, like it's, I think it's the love that transcends the emotion. The love that is
compassion, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. Maybe even bigger than that. Yeah, like something, like not personal love. But to me, personally, I'm a bit more selfish, so... so I feel... like the brightest love that I experience, or I can imagine experience, is personal love.
How is it beyond emotion?
Beyond emotion, it's something that is like a, it's something eternal, something is inevitable. Yeah, it's not like today I have life, tomorrow I don't have. It's constant, there's something behind.
Beyond Cupid.
Huh?
Beyond Cupid.
Beyond Cupid, yeah. Not only beyond Cupid, yeah. Beyond tempo, beyond everything. Yeah. Beyond books, beyond words. Beyond our body. There's something beyond here, beyond there, beyond now, beyond time. But here, what I'm going to play like is something more selfish love. Something the some life that is everlasting. I was imagining like, can I tell a very personal story?
Sure.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah, I'm always like the other day I met a guy, and then like we only spent like one night together. But I and then like, you know, we didn't develop anything. But and then I already feel such a grief. And I'm imagining, because I'm not living long enough, I don't know, imagining like if someone you have been together for 30 years and then it departs of you, what kind of grief? Like, I feel like the heartache, it's like, even like just such a short time, it takes me 3 days to like experience this very deep pain. Yeah. And I don't know like if someone has been like 30 years or like your whole life and suddenly departed, what kind of grief? Wow. Well, yeah, I was imagining that. And anyway, like here, I want to, I had the story that I had in mind is like when I was with my loved one at the end of our life, and then I guess sooner or later one of us must departed from each other. So can like when the departure and then turns into something eternal love, there's reconciliation inside. And of course, I think like music, like how to say, there's nothing to talk about music. Yeah. So, it's like you do not necessarily to put what I'm going to play into what I'm telling you. And you feel what you feel.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much for everyone coming. And there is a hat again. So
help Julian pay rent.
You're very welcome to contribute. And I have a ritual here. Is that at the end I always sing a song together with everyone, and I always sing the same song. So you're very welcome to join me. Thank you.
baby. To warm this lonely night, please let me love you, baby. Everyone, I love you. Let me love you. I can't take my eyes off you. Thank you. Instead of playing classical music, is that like improvisation? Like I can always feel how the audience feel, and then I will like in some moment I will like you know,
slide along.
Exactly, this is a good word. Yeah. So, but anyway, I'm looking forward to seeing you in next week here at 8 o'clock at the same time. And I enjoy it so much. It's truly my honor and my pleasure to be here. Okay, so please welcome Jay and Vicky and whatever. And,